Here at the McNeil Studios down here in beautiful Baja Tustin, we have Professor Mark McNeil talking about pure competition versus pure monopoly.
Thank you. Hold your applause for later. Here we are in beautiful Baja Tustin International Film Studios to talk about pure competition versus pure monopoly. What's the difference? Well, this is an industry. Both are industries. This is a purely competitive industry. Many small firms, homogeneous product, free entry and exit. And this is supply curve is the sum of the marginal cost curves for each firm in the industry. And this demand curve is the demand for all consumers or buyers in this industry. And out of this market process comes price, this price, PC we'll call it, and this quantity, QPC, for pure competition. And if we continue this up a little bit, this entire area is the difference between the maximum this consumer is willing to pay and what they actually pay, which is the market price. Maximum, actual. And all of these little stripy lines represent each of these buyers' consumer surplus. And so this whole stripy area represents the total of consumer surplus when the quantity produced is that quantity. Consumer surplus. Then all of this green stripy area, where is it? Represents producer surplus. That's right. The difference between what they receive and what their opportunity costs are. The supply curve shows you the opportunity costs. So all of this is producer surplus, and then down here is the opportunity cost of producing this quantity. Opportunity cost down here. Now, what if I, J.P. McNeil, form a trust, and I advertise the trust and I say, I'm going to buy every firm in this industry. This was the trust movement in the late 1800s in the United States. And that's why the antitrust laws were established, because people like JP would establish a trust and people would put their money into the trust fund, and when the trust fund got to be a big enough amount or whatever they had specified it would be, then JP or whoever was forming the trust would go buy every firm in that industry. I don't know if it was every single one, but certainly buy the industry. And then they would turn it into a monopoly. And presumably from the monopoly profits, then the investors would find it profitable to invest in this. So let's say that I become JP Morgan and I take this industry and turn it into a monopoly. So what will I do? Well, I now own every firm. So this would be like a firm, every one of the firms is a different producer, but it's one organization, one company. So I don't care any longer what is the demand. I care about marginal revenue because there's one seller. So the marginal revenue in this industry, and I'm going to charge everybody one price. There's no price discrimination here. So that's the marginal revenue curve when there's no price discrimination. And this supply curve is something like the sum of the marginal cost curves. It's close enough to supply. And so if this is the marginal cost, that's the marginal revenue. This will be the quantity I will choose to produce. That will be my monopoly quantity, profit maximizing, where marginal revenue equals marginal cost. And the price I will charge comes from demand. So this is the price the monopoly will charge. So you can see that, first of all, the price is higher and the quantity produced is lower. Now, what about this area here? The difference between the maximum these consumers are willing to pay and what they actually paid, then this is consumer surplus. Much smaller, yes? And then the difference between these opportunity costs here and what the seller receives, this is producer surplus. Opportunity cost is this area here. But do you see this area right here? This little triangle? this triangle here is a deadweight loss. It's lost wealth because of some market restriction. And I, J.P. McNeil, have cut back the quantity that would have been in a purely competitive environment. I have cut it back to this quantity, the monopoly quantity, for the purposes of being able to raise the price. By cutting back on quantity, I'm able to raise the price to the industry profit maximizing quantity and price combination. And as a result, I have decreased consumer surplus and increased producer surplus. So how do monopolies compare with purely competitive industries based on price? It's higher. Quantity, it's lower. Consumer surplus gets smaller with monopolies. Producer surplus gets larger with monopolies. And is there deadweight loss? No deadweight loss in pure competition, but in pure monopoly, yes, there is. So there we have it, the difference between pure competition and pure monopoly. Now, for your forbearance and patience, I will tell you a very slight story here about economists. Economists are very forthright. And what that means is they're right a fourth of the time. I know. Okay. Just one more. If we were to line up all the economists in the world, end to end, they still wouldn't reach a conclusion. I know. Thank you very much. That's it. It's time to turn this off.